Ladies and gentlemen, the Side Notes host, please welcome Attorney Ray Chris Panugaling and Dr. Helen Madamba.
Maayong hapon mga ka-vibes nga nagtan-aw karon diha sa inyo mga panimalay.
Welcome sa atong bag-o gipanindot ug gipalanog nga Soto Live Season 3.
Yes, Doc Helen, sa atong Soto Live Season 3, every Monday na atay the doctor is here. And every Tuesday is Tatak Soto and every Wednesday is I Connect. So Doc Helen, unsa may bag-o sa Soto Live Season 3 every Thursday?
Yes, attorney, I'm so excited on this one. We have a new program or segment every Thursday, 5 in the afternoon. We call it The Side Notes, VSMMC Documentaries. So, this will showcase the patient's journey and their experience towards healing. It will also feature the patient's road to recovery. It also includes breakthrough development and innovations and complex medical cases of this institution.
Wow, so it will capture, Dr. Helen, the human dapat bibiay atangan mga kabayatong inadlaw-adlaw sa every Thursday, no? Kada Huwebes, diri sa Soto Live. And so, Dr. Helen, unsay nakahaani ang nakalahi aning side notes from the previous natong mga Soto Live?
Ang kakaiba dito sa side notes, attorney, and mga ka-vibes, is that isa itong documentary of a certain case of a patient that will feature his or her life after being diagnosed by a certain disease and his or her admission and stay in VSMMC until the day the patient is discharged, as well as the patient's road to recovery.
So, nindot yun din siya, no, Dr. Helen and mga ka-vibes. So, ang mga storya nga atong i-feature diri, Dr. Helen, will always showcase empathy, change minds, influence behavior, and bring also communities together or social awareness sa atong mga ka-vibes. Very good.
Yes, oo. It will also give inspiration sa atong mga viewers or sa atong mga ka-vibes nga nag-atang aning atong bagong programa.
Alright, so kung sa one network, Dr. Helen, maayo kay na sila sa entertainment, and the other networks also, maayo po sila sa news and public affairs, diri unya sa VSMMC will be known unya tadiri as on the social awareness and more of human interest. Right? Yes, unsa may dapat nato mga atangan, Dr. Helen, sa atong mga ka-vibes, aning nga programa?
For the side notes, VSMMC documentaries, we have several episodes on one particular patient. The first episode, we will know the patient, his or her situation after being diagnosed with a certain disease or his or her situation before Soto. And then the second episode will be the Soto care. The third episode is the patient's road to recovery. The fourth episode is the patient's current situation and testimonial.
So, inani gyud siya, Dr. Helen, no, og mga ka-vibes nga ato gyud ding ipakita ang usa ka journey sa atong pasyente.
Yes.
Nga gikan sa pag-admit hangtod sa pag-discharge diri sa atong tambalanan. So it is like a whole month nga coverage diri sa side notes, Dr. Helen, right?
Yes, attorney, you're right. So I'm really looking forward to this segment. Excited ka na ba, attorney? Kamo mga ka-vibes, excited na ba mo?
Wow, I'm sure Dr. Helen excited na kaayo ta doc and excited na kita mauli og balik sa Cebu karon dayon.
Yes, agree.
Right? All right. So I am inviting mga ka-vibes nga to like our official social media accounts through our Facebook and Twitter at official VSMMC. We also have our official website for vsmmc.doh.gov.ph. And you can also contact us through our email address at osm@vsmmc.doh.gov.ph. So makita na ninyo na sa mga screen mga ka-vibes. Kay wala pa man tayo karong hapuna, Dr. Helen. Mas maayo siguro atong hisgutan ang atong mga major takeaways and messages based sa atong experience sa International Hospital Federation sa Barcelona, Spain. So I think, Dr. Helen, mas maayos siguro ikay mo una mo pa inform sa ato ang mga ka-vibes unsa imong mga major takeaways sa IHF or the 44th World Hospital Congress sa Barcelona, Spain. Dr. Helen?
Actually, yes, Attorney, no, we are very blessed, no, to have been able to experience firsthand ang 44th International Hospital Federation World Congress. And we have, ako personally, I have four takeaways or key points na I would like to share to everyone. No. The first is, COVID really affected the whole world. It's a shared experience. For all. Across all hospitals, and everyone had to cope and adjust, and they shared the best practices, whether it's a third world country, a first world country, everyone in the whole world are affected by COVID-19, and they have to learn to live in the new normal and live with COVID. The second point is that everyone should be vaccinated to prevent severe and critical COVID-19. Because I think, no, we will really never be able to engineer our societies and our environment to prevent infection. But at least with vaccination, we can prevent severe and critical COVID-19 and reduce the burden on the hospitals and reduce the expenses of COVID-19.
Sakto.
And so, ang third pa, I think every locality has different rules and regulations as far as COVID-19 protocols are concerned, but consistent use of face masks in closed spaces should be universal across all cities, countries, no? If you're in a closed space, because it's all about ventilation, you have to wear face mask. And we have to be in open air, al fresco, well-ventilated areas for us to remove our face masks. Like if you're dining outside, no, it has to be outside, not indoors. So that's right. The safest way to be able to remove your face mask. Otherwise, we have to always be wearing our face masks in closed spaces. Yan. And then the fourth point or key point is that hospitals need to reform. Because we have to keep improving. It's continuous improvement. So we have to reform as far as digital transformation, governance, cultural sensitivity, environmental sustainability, and leadership is concerned. I hope yes. that in the future we can discuss more about this, even in our attendance of the Philippine Hospital Association annual convention. Some of these ideals and concepts have been discussed, so I'm kind of excited because there are a lot of things that we can do to reform the hospitals.
It means
and
to
the
say Dr. Helen more works, no?
Work. Just like Dr. Aquino said, no, more work when we come back. Ikaw, attorney, what are your takeaways?
Ako, major lang siguro sa travel, the advantage of vaccination. Because, you know, ang mga tao manggod uban is very still hesitant na pati mga ka-vibes na wapa siguro na bakunahan. Mm-hmm. So, I would like really say that when you are a traveler by heart, okay, and you want to enjoy outside the country, it's best and it is the only choice, which is magpabakuna. Because once you have a vaccination card, like naamanta sa BOQ, no, that is already considered and recognized abroad. So once you are vaccinated, you can just present it and that is already your key to your destination.
Yes.
So ina na ang advantage, mga ka-vibes, especially kung gusto ka mahaon o restaurant outside the country, like in Europe, pangitaan kita og vaccination card. Dili na lang, di gud ganina ang card nga card lang. It's really the one being recognized by the Bureau of Quarantine. Ang sa Spain, like sa Spain, simpler siya because ang ato ang BOQ is already recognized in Spain. But for other European countries, kinahanglan pa gyud siya ipa-convert into a European EU QR code. So, but still, the bottom line ananiya is dapat nakabakuna jud ka. And even sa pag-abot na to diri sa Pilipinas, number one question is, are you vaccinated? Because when you are vaccinated, it's not nga fast lane, but you will be out of some processes nga dili na kinahanglan sa mga nagpabakuna na. So it will be easier for you. So it is again an advantage. So kana siya mga ka-vibes, kung mahimo, naamang yun yung mga kaila nga gusto di kayo mag-travel, even local travel, like Boracay is already open to those who are vaccinated. Baler, Aurora is already open. Daghan na kayo mga tourist destinations nga open, Dr. Helen, tungod sa pagbabakuna. So, in the IHF, what we learn is that ang major takeaway dito is no one is safe until everybody is safe. So, the vaccination is really the key. Okay? It's really the key. Namagaroy balita sa usa ka European country nga taas jugay lang cases. And when you look at their vaccination rate, it's very low. So, that is why vaccination is really an answer to what we are experiencing. So, I hope mga ka-vibes ato na siyang i-embrace na reality that kinahanglan na tagbakuna. In fact, Dr. Helen, di ba? Mga healthcare workers karon start na og booster. So
yes,
that's very good.
Okay, in the near future.
So around, yes, in the near future, padung na po na sa tanan na to sa other members of the population. So kana mga ka-vibes, bisag asa dapita, vaccination is really the answer. Mapa-Europe, mapa-Pilipinas, it's really needed all over the world. So muna siya ako ang mga major takeaways, no, when we were traveling to Spain, na it's really something advantageous yung Dr. Helen kung nabakunahan ka. And
last,
Dr. Helen, it's leadership. Ang tanan nga panghitabo sulod sa usa ka hospital, just like us in the medical center, the major role you diha is leadership. That's the secret in digitalization, in green hospital, in whatever innovation you would like nga imuhang implement sa hospital, it will always go back to leadership. That's the
and political will of the leader.
And major, yes, major consideration. So mana, we are very excited mga ka-vibes to share to you all of these documentaries in the future. So, dili lang din na sa side notes ninyo makitaan. Right?
Yes. So, to everyone all over the world, especially to our Filipino, fellow Filipinos, stay tuned and catch us live every Thursday at 5 p.m. Kay nga no, RC?
Because kay dinhi sa Soto, kalidad nga serbisyo among garbo.
So, this is Helen.
And this is RC. Ug mao kini ang
The Side Notes, the VSMMC
documentaries.
Thank you. Salamat.